Hello. Oh,
it broke.
Yeah, this is broken. I'm pretending it isn't. Maybe if I don't move too much, it'll stay in place. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm bringing you what I watched in April. Spoiler alert, I watched a lot of things in April, and it's making May this month look really bad because so far I've only watched one movie. Next month's video is gonna be very interesting. I've watched some TV shows though, so I'll talk about that for sure. But as far as movies, please leave me any recommendations you have because this month I'm just lacking in movies. I don't know, I think, you know what? I've been playing Pokemon Snap every night instead of watching a movie. I used to watch like a movie every day. Now I'm just playing games. I'm just playing Pokemon Snap. It's very cute. For April, I don't know what happened, but I was just in a rom-com fever. I just needed to watch every single rom-com that I used to love when I was a teenager. I think, you know what it is? I've been watching a lot of Modern Girls videos and I love her videos a lot, and she talks a lot about 2000's movies, so she got me very, very nostalgic. I just decided to, you know, go into this rabbit hole of all of these movies that I used to love, starting with Ella Enchanted. Honestly, I did not remember Ella Enchanted to be this iconic. Like, I have no other word for it, but this movie should be talked about way more. It's just way too underrated. I mean, the musical numbers, like, they sing Queen. And even the humor, they're just, I hadn't realized this when I was a kid, but they're literally just making fun of all of these fairy tale stories, and I just thought it was very smart. But you know, I love Anne Hathaway, and that's why I also decided to rewatch The Princess Diaries 2, A Royal Engagement. Yes, I was one of the people that had a crush on Michael on the first Princess Diaries, so the idea of him not being in the second movie was just very painful for my little teenage heart. But you know, once I saw Chris Pine, I forgot about Michael. Yeah, Chris Pine was like the perfect pick for this role. I love their like enemies to lovers trope, but there is one couple that I feel like just tops all couples in The Princess Diaries, and that is Clarice and Joe. They are extremely cute. I just love them and I want them to be my grandparents. I love how Mia was able to stand up for herself at the end and rewriting Genovia's loss. She was able to rule as a single gal. Then I watched a Sofia Coppola film that I had not seen before, and that is The Bling Ring. I actually love Sofia Coppola's films, but The Bling Ring just never really caught my attention that much. It was just sort of, it just didn't look that enticing, I don't know. And I wasn't really too familiar with the whole Bling Ring story, the actual events that happened, but I decided to finally watch it, and I mean, it wasn't very memorable. It was just very meh. I honestly just got bored, and I was at least expecting some like good outfits, but not even that. Like, those were bad as well. Cinematography was all right. I did like one shot, and that is this white shot that they did when they were robbing Adrena Patrick. I really liked that shot and I liked the soundtrack, but other than that, it was just a movie that I don't really want to watch again. Then we picked it back up with the 2000s rom-coms and I watched Just My Luck. I used to love this movie as a teen. I don't know what it was. I think it was like the combination of Lindsay being this fabulous like New Yorker, and then of course Chris Pine. We've established before that I like Chris Pine, so it was just kind of like a perfect pair. I must say it's like a pretty dumb movie, but honestly it's fun. I don't know if it's the nostalgia because I really liked it when I was a teen, but or a kid, I don't know when I watched it. I love seeing Lindsay Lohan in movies. I kind of miss seeing her in those types of movies. She was really the it girl. Then I rewatched The Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants, another one that I used to love. I think what I liked the most was kind of the adventure feel that it has, because each girl obviously goes on her own adventure. I love all of the different storylines and how each girl grew from each experience. One thing though that I noticed this time around is that Carmen's dad is an absolute scum. He does not deserve to be forgiven by Carmen. Even when Carmen left crying, she called him on the phone, she told him how he felt, he stayed silent and he did not call her back He did not go and visit her at her house. No, he did not deserve to be forgiven. He did not deserve for her to show up at his wedding. The screenwriters really messed up. Then I rewatched one of my all-time favorites, and it's Legally Blonde. Honestly, I think Legally Blonde is one of the greatest movies ever made. It's one of the best movies of the 21st century. And honestly, I just watch it every now and then because one, I love it. Two, if I'm feeling like not good and I just want to watch something that will cheer me up, I'll watch it. And three, honestly, film schools should study this movie. Moving on, I will not accept Legally Blonde slander, so if you're planning on writing it in the comments, just don't. No, I'm kidding, you can write your opinions, it's fine. Then I watched Cruel Intentions for the very first time. I did not expect it to be so angsty, I guess. I don't know, it's just the whole like step-siblings kind of threw me off. Also, the fact that he was like bullet journaling the whole time, that just does it for me. I did love the Bittersweet Symphony scene. I had seen that scene before because I love that song. Then I rewatched The Holiday, which is one of my favorite rom-coms. I don't know why, but before when I was a teen and I used to watch this movie, I always loved the Cameron Diaz Jude Law storyline way more. But this time around, the Kate Winslet Jack Black storyline was way more entertaining for me. I think that as people, I see myself being friends with Kate Winslet's character and Jack Black's character way more than the other two. I also really like that Jack Black is the love interest here, and it's great that in the movie they don't even mention his weight or his look or anything. He's just a great guy. Then I rewatched How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days, and I had seen this one a long time ago. Even though I didn't remember as much, I could predict everything that was gonna happen. But you know what? I had fun. Moving on, I watched Shiva Baby. Okay, this one was freaking amazing. It just perfectly portrayed the anxiety of having to go to these family reunions, having absolutely everyone and their mother ask you about your life, about your career plans, even about your weight and how much you're eating or how little you're eating. It was so hilarious too. I absolutely loved the writing and the score was perfect. It really pushed that suspense because even though this movie was hilarious, it was also full of suspense. I did not know what was gonna happen. The music really portrayed that, and overall, I love this movie. Then I rewatched Ocean Waves from Studio Ghibli. It's honestly a movie that it's not one of my favorites from Ghibli because I just find it a little bit angsty and too kind of melodramatic. But you know, if you like those 90s anime vibes and if you can identify with some of the characters which are angsty teenagers, then you'll probably like this one. It's just not one of my favorite Ghibli. I feel like Ghibli has a lot of gems and this one's not necessarily one of them. Then I watched Bridget Jones' Diary for the very first time. I had not seen this movie before. It's not one of my favorite rom-coms. Maybe it's because I'm just now watching it and I didn't watch it back then when it came out, so I don't have kind of that attachment to it. But yeah, it was just a fun movie. Then I watched Julie and Julia for the very first time as well. This one I wasn't really a fan of. I did not like Julie's character. I thought she was pretty annoying. I'm sorry, Amy Adams, you do not deserve this. I love food in movies and like movies about cooking. It just makes me hungry. But even the food in this movie didn't really look that appetizing. I feel like maybe the cinematography, they didn't really capture the food that well. It was okay. I like Meryl Streep though. I mean, she's always great in everything, so. Then I rewatched another Ghibli film only yesterday, which is a literal masterpiece. This is Isao Takahata's best film in my opinion. I just love how nostalgic it is and how it works through memories. It's just a beautiful movie. We know that Miyazaki's movies are the ones that are more famous, but I really urge you to watch Isao Takahata's movies, and specifically this one, I really, really like it. Then I rewatched John Tucker Must Die, another movie that I used to love when I was a teen, and honestly, I did not realize it back then, but I'm pretty sure everyone in this movie is at least 27 years old. Also, this movie is just the perfect blend of Mean Girls and High School Musical. I'm actually planning to make a TikTok about that because it's just crazy. There's a lot of wrong things about this movie, but it's just one of those really stupid movies I feel like you had to have watched when you were a teen back in the 2000s, or else you won't like it now. I don't think you. Then I rewatched Bring It On, and I love sports movies, and by sports movies I just mean Bring It On and probably any movie about figure skating. This one just makes me so nostalgic. I love seeing Kirsten Dunst as Torrance. I think she did a really great job, but we all know why we watched this movie, and it's because of these three. These three are just the best thing about this movie. None of the sequels compare to this one. That intro scene when they're all saying their names and turns out, oh, it's a dream. Just perfect, iconic. Then I rewatched both Minari and Parasite because if you guys saw, I posted a video about both Minari and Parasite where I analyzed both movies and I gave my own opinions about them and also went deep into both movies' family dynamics. Of course, both movies feature families as the main characters, so I went really deep on that, on each family. It was more like a video essay type thing, movie review, so if you guys are interested in that, I'm gonna leave the link in the description and also at the end. And I finished the month with two movies that I had been meaning to watch for a long time, but I never did before, and it's Paddington. People were saying that Paddington 2 is better than Citizen Kane, and honestly, I agree. Let's start with Paddington. I watched Paddington 1, and you know, I'm not gonna lie, 8 minutes in, I was like, this is gonna be sad, they're gonna die, and then he's gonna be all alone. I don't know, I was just preparing myself. But you know what? This is not Disney. Basically, the whole movie was just so cute. It was just pure sunshine, and I really, really liked it. And I kind of wish I could have seen it before so I could include it in my movies that are pure serotonin list, because yeah, this is the definition of serotonin. And of course, I followed up with Paddington 2. It's one of the most charming and enjoyable movies that I've ever seen. It literally felt kind of like a warm hug. I was just like laying in my bed, tucked into my blanket, just watching Paddington 2. I was happy. I was truly happy. I really liked the cinematography. It reminded me a lot of a Wes Anderson movie, specifically the Grand Budapest Hotel with the whole prison escape. It really reminded me of it. And it was honestly so charming. The characters are all super likable, especially Paddington. How could you make such a lovable character? I don't know. I love his mean stare. It's just all of these little quirky things that make him so lovable. And that ending, wow, I was crying so much. Yeah, this is way better than Citizen Kane. I'm so sorry, but it is. Citizen Kane is like taught in every single film class, but they should really teach Paddington 2. I said what I said. Okay, that is every single movie that I watched in April. I warn you, it was all rom-coms, 2000s, and just some random little things here and there. I guess I just did not want to watch anything depressing last month. Let me know what you guys watched recently. I really need recommendations because, like I said, I've only watched one movie this month. And if you watched any of the movies that I mentioned, please let me know what your opinions on them are. Okay, thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna go get vaccinated now, which is very exciting. And yeah, I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.